Hey guys, this is going to be a quick one. So, if you're like me, you may have struggled to find a cheap source for small size pots like this. And prices have been fluctuating a lot. If you go on Amazon, at the time of this recording, they actually have become more affordable again recently. But a little while previous to this, they were prohibitively expensive. They were like maybe 50 for around $15. If you really dug around, you could find maybe 100 or 150 for similar $15 to $20. But if you don't want to deal with trying to find the best deal, then you could just cut out all that and get cups. So what's better than 50 or 100 or even 150? How about 200 and just drill holes in the bottom of them? I came across this from somebody else and he wasn't even talking about it. It was just like in the background of his video, him putting some holes in cups. And I'm like, what? That's smart. Why haven't I thought about this? So I got a box of 200 for around $12, $13. So I'm getting twice the amount for a similar price. Because I might not even be able to find the actual plastic pots at the time that I got these. And just put holes in them. So I like to do it maybe 5-6 at a time, just hold it, put some holes in it, and then shake the excess off into the trash here. And it goes by pretty fast. I've drilled about 100 in just about 5 minutes, and I've got a bunch of pots. It's not perfect drainage, as you can see. It's not the same as this where that has a bunch of holes in it. You could do that, but you mess with the structural stability the more holes you drill into it. So these are just going to be like transitionary. They're not going to be in these forever, whatever I plant in them. So this drainage is okay for me. You could put more holes in it if you want. You could even use a smaller drill bit to try and punch this many holes. You know, do whatever you feel like doing with it. But this was a really cheap and affordable way to get this size of pot or something very close at the time. And I mean, who's to say prices don't stay the same at all times? They'll probably fluctuate again. So it's a resourceful idea to have in your back pocket to just get like some Dixie cups or something and turn them into pots. And similarly, I've talked about it in the past, but I do the same thing with buckets that had honey in them that are food grade, so they're safe to plant into. I just drill holes in them and save some money in the process. So that's just a pretty quick and easy way to get this size of pot. If you don't have this size of pot readily available to you in your area or not at a reasonable price, this is a good alternative to that.